Hey everybody, after a long winter, spring is finally here. And guess what that means? The fish are starting to bite. We're on location to bring you all the latest fishing and get things kicked off for the 2017 season of our show. Glad to have you along. We're at the lake and Fox Sports Outdoors launches for 2017 right now.
Watching the only program with weekly fishing reports and real-time outdoor news from the Southwest region. This is Fox Sports Outdoors.
Hey everyone, so glad you're along with us for episode number one of 39 consecutive brand new episodes of Fox Sports Outdoors in the 2017 season. We're going to be bringing you all the latest fishing, lake, and saltwater reports from the Southeast and Southwest regions, our entire 10-state area, with all of our insider reporters. I'll be your captain, your host, along with a few other guest hosts along the way. We'll be bringing you all the latest fishing each and every week. And we begin the year in early March where the weather's warming, the water is warming, and that means one thing, the bass are biting. So to get things started, we're bringing you early spring bass fishing tips and techniques today. To do that, I'd like to welcome you into a lake I've never laid eyes on before. This is Walter E. Long Lake. It's located just east of the city of Austin, Texas. It's got a lot of bass in it. We're going to be talking about why smaller lakes are the perfect setups for you to catch early spring bass. We'll give you all the reasons why coming up. Now, let me show you something else really cool. Today is the first maiden voyage for the brand new Tracker Pro Team 195. This is the top of the line aluminum fishing boat package. I've got it completely rigged out with the Mercury 115 horsepower four-stroke outboard engine. I love the four strokes because they're quiet, they're smooth, a lot of reasons for that. I've got the power pole blades on the back, we've got carpet, live wells, upholstery, consoles. I've got the Lowrance Elite TI fish finder units on there, and I'll explain more about those as we go along. Got a Motor Guide X3 trolling motor on the front, fishing chairs, everything you could possibly want in a fully loaded aluminum fishing rig. We're going to be launching it for the very first time on today's show. So let's get the boat down the boat ramp, get things started, and to kick it off, let's go back to the FSN studios for your very first weekend planner.
Hi everyone, and welcome back to another year of Fox Sports Outdoors. We're anticipating more fantastic fishing in 2017, and I've got some good news to start the season. We'll have a full moon Sunday, and the Saloonar tables are very optimistic for game fish activity. Both days this weekend are forecast to have some of the best action of the month. Peak daylight hours should begin at 12:03 on Saturday and 1:50 on Sunday. Look for the sun to rise at 6:42 a.m. and set at 6:32 p.m. on Saturday. And then everything moves forward an hour on Sunday at 2 a.m. Remember to move those clocks ahead 1 hour for daylight savings time.
Fox Sports Outdoors is brought to you by Tracker Boats. It's more than a boat, it's a tracker. Mercury Marine, go boldly. Lowrance Electronics, celebrating 60 years of fish finding excellence. Find, navigate, dominate. And Costa Sunglasses, see what's out there.
There's a good start for you right there. Good bass. Grass in there, a lot of hydrilla. There's one. Come out of that grass. Oh, he's in it. Come out, baby. Well, I got a bite on a spinner bait. All right, I got fish, grass. There we go. There's a good start for you right there. A good bass right up in the grass. Welcome back, everybody. Well, we're coming to you, as I mentioned, from a lake I've never seen before. Walter E. Long or Decker Lake, Austin, Texas, but we're really just kind of using this as an experiment to show you what we're going to do. If you're on the hunt for some good bass in the early springtime, like we're in right now. So there's one, I'm going to let him go back. Let's start off talking about location. It's always about that. How do you choose a spot where you're gonna fish. And I talked at the outset about choosing a smaller lake for two main reasons. Reason number one, wind protection. You wanna fish warmer water. In the springtime, the bass are gonna move towards shallow, warmer water, and the smaller lakes are more protected from the wind, not nearly as much open water, and the water will warm a little quicker because of the lack of wind action. Number two, depth. Smaller lakes are usually shallower. Shallower water warms quicker, and you can actually catch one on a spinnerbait early in the spring. There's just a good chartreuse spinnerbait with a couple of blades, little trailer hook. Great action right there. Find that location of a smaller lake, warmer water, you'll get bit quicker. Let's get you fishing and lake reports to get started for 2017 from where you live.
Hi folks, and welcome to our very first Lone Star Lakes of the new season, brought to you by Ulrich Barns and Cabins. Whether you need a cabin by the lake, a barn to put your boat in, or just a place for your stuff, let's see what Ulrich can build for you. Now we're here today on Little Marine Creek Reservoir just outside the city of Fort Worth. It's only 250 acres, but for a small lake, it's given up some big fish, including the first Sherilunker of the season this year. Now that's a fish over 13 pounds, and that certainly gets my attention. It was caught here just off the banks on a jerk bait, which was the hard treble hooked kind, not those soft plastic ones. But bring your jerk baits, bring your lizards, bring your Texas rigs, and bring your mini Carolina rig. That's a 1/4 ounce weight, about 18 inches from the hook, with a lizard or a craw on the end. Use your watermelon colors, your red craw type colors, or your black blues for your best results on Marine Creek. Out on Ray Roberts, crappie are starting to move up in the creeks, and you'll be able to catch them up in the shallow brush about 2 to 5 feet deep using your standard crappie baits. Now let's check in with Mr. Bill Olson. He's on the coast.
Hi folks, this week's report is brought to you by Port Aransas on Mustang Island, the fishing capital of Texas, where anglers enjoy pristine bays, estuaries, 18 miles of surf, and the deep blue waters of the Gulf of Mexico. Plus, the local restaurants will even cook your catch come sundown. Come fish and play Texas Island style. For more information, visit portaransas.org. Well, my last report to end 2016 said the weather forecast called for mild winter, and it has been just that. Coastal water temperatures that normally drop into the 40s never occurred. Usually this time of year, we're working our way through the 60s, headed toward that magical 70 degree mark. On most of the coast, we are at or have surpassed that mark. Start off the spring with smaller baits to match the hatch. Specks are already working grassy areas. On cooler days, look for darker bottoms with mud grass areas, and on warmer days, look for sand grass areas. Back lakes and marshes are in play with plenty of good trout and reds. Don't discount the redfish, as they are aggressively feeding and some good trout are hanging around picking up an easy meal. Finally, there'll be days when we need to hide from the wind, so watch the forecast and plan accordingly. This weekend, both Saturday and Sunday have a double tide schedule of 2 high and 2 low tides each day. I'm Bill Olson, and I'll see you on the coast.
That's a decent one. Got a big old mouthful of lipless rattlebait. Here he comes. Oh, it's a decent fish. Look at him. That's a decent one. He's got a big old mouthful of lipless rattlebait. Don't hook me. All right. Hey, welcome back, everybody. We are giving you a few lessons on early springtime bass and how to find them, how to locate them, and how to catch them. I'm going to have to do a little bit of surgery on this fish, but while I do, you know, we've already talked about location, about where or what lakes to go to, the size of the lake, and why you want to fish small lakes like this one. Back that fish goes, see ya. So let's move now to, once you're at the lake, what are you looking for in the early spring like we are right now? Once this water begins to warm up, you're looking for outside edges. What do I mean by that? The outside edge of a grass bed where it falls off into deep water. the outside tip of a point, outside of a rock pile, outside of a jetty, last stump in a long row of stumps before it drops off into deep water. The first place those fish can contact a piece of structure coming from deep towards shallow, outside of a creek channel, mouth of a cove, all great spots. Hey, got a good fish. Time for fishing and lake reports for you right now from where you live.
Hey friends, Captain Kevin Broussard here, welcoming you back to Fox Sports Outdoor Report. Tell you what, old Cajun Phil and Captain Kevin are gonna be bringing you the Louisiana freshwater and Louisiana saltwater. Some weeks it'll be just me doing both, some weeks it'll be just Pop doing both. Right now, we're up at Toledo Bend. I'll tell you what, a little springtime bass action. They're up real shallow, some of them are on the beds. Saltwater, I tell you what, it's actually going great. Calcasieu Lake, lots of speckled trout all the way up to the north end of the estuary, Lake Charles and Prion. 1/4 ounce Rockport Rattler with soft plastic seems to be the key there. Toefield Bourgeois down out of Lafitte, and lots of redfish getting caught over there. So I tell you what, it's springtime, we're having a little warmer than average year. All I can tell you is get out on the water. For old Cajun Phil, I'm Captain Kevin Broussard, saying happy fishing, may God bless, and we'll see you next week.
Got him, come up. He's got a bunch of grass again. This is not near as big a fish as what it's making out to be just because of all this grass. Ah. You want the bait touching the cover. So you want to let it get down, slow it down enough. How about that? Watch this. Away he goes. You want to slow it down enough. In this case, where the bait is actually touching the top of the grass bed or the outside of the grass bed, you want to feel the bait actually bump in to the stump, the rock, the grass, whatever it is you're fishing. You want to feel the bait touch it, and that's what draws that strike because those fish are laying right next to that cover.
Fox Sports Outdoors is brought to you by Lose, fueled by passion, driven by innovation. Feel the difference. Gene LaRue Bass Baits and Bobby Garland Crappie Baits, the leaders in soft plastic lures innovation. And Nitro Performance Fishing Boats. Champions aren't born, they're made.
Stay out of the grass. I want one fish to not get in this grass, and he didn't. He's out of it. Boy, they immediately bury their head down in that hydrilla, and I gotta go over here and chase them down. Oh yeah, that's a good fish. Good fish with a lot of grass on him. Come up here, darling. Yeah, I got him. All right. And they've got 6 hooks to have a choice of. Look at that fat, that's a female. See the extended belly? Fish moving up, getting ready to go into bed. That's just a good solid fish, good bass right there. So, let's put him back for you. How about that? Back he goes. You're looking for that water temperature to hit 56, 57 degrees for the bass to go into their pre-spawn mode. That means they've moved up out of deep water onto those outside edges and they actually start feeding. They don't feed a whole lot during the cold winter time, but you get them moved up on these edges and they're hungry. These fish are active and they're actively feeding and they will chase a bait down. They'll bite a lipless rattling crankbait. You saw me catch one on a big spinnerbait earlier, slow rolling it on those outside edges. But a big lipless rattlebait right there will catch them. Then, when the water temp gets over 60 to 61, 62 in that range, they will actually move shallow up into 3 foot of water, 4 foot, and they'll make those beds on the bottom. Males move in, make the bed, female comes in, spawns, lays the eggs, and that's the process. But it begins right now when that water temperature where you live first hits the upper 50s or right around 60 degrees. That's what you're looking for. And what you're looking for is more fishing and lake reports from our insider reporter where you live.
Hey, welcome back to Fox Sports Outdoors and Sooner Beat. It's my pleasure to once again be bringing you the weekly fishing updates from the state of Oklahoma. And like most parts in the region, we just didn't have much of a winter here. As a result of that, our fishing and fishing conditions are about a month ahead of where they typically are for this time of year. Now, good bass reports and crappie reports coming in from many places across the state, and a few lakes are really shining. In particular, Lake Texoma, Charles Jewell tells me he's catching quality largemouth and smallmouth, throwing medium to deep diving crankbaits, 6 to 10 foot of water. Lake Ten Killer is another great bass lake. Lots of good largemouth and smallmouth already coming on biffle bugs and hardheads. Guys are targeting the shallow main lake points that are next to some of the spawning banks. The fish are starting to move. Crappie fishing, three lakes in particular, are extremely hot. Skytook Lake has been really good for a while now. Lots of crappie out in the open water following the school of shad. Now they're getting closer to the banks, and even in the evening, some up on the banks and catch them under a bobber. Same thing down at Kerr Reservoir. Good fishing there for crappie too. A lot of fish coming from that 4 to 6 foot of water. And then Lake Eufaula, off to a wonderful start this year. I-40 bridge all the way down to the extreme southern end there at Gaines Creek. Now the muddier water, throw those black hot pink colors, the clearer waters, the Bobby Garland baby shad, and the monkey milk and mayfly doing extremely well. You can catch them pretty much anywhere in Oklahoma right now, but you can't catch them if you don't go.
There's one. Stay out of the grass. I want one fish and not get in this grass. And he didn't. He's got it right under the chin. There we go. Come up here, buddy. That's a fat one. Look at that. And he's got a whole bunch of hooks in him. All right. Little chunk for you. Ooh, I'm going to have to do a little surgery on that fish. That's a wide body right there. Look how fat. That's another female moving up to spawn. Hey, let me mention one other thing before we go to a quick break right here. The way you're going to tell if there's vegetation, which is key for this time of the year, we talked about moving up on the outside edges of the vegetation. You can locate that stuff by finding the coots. These are these black birds that dive down and feed on that vegetation. So if you just scan your eye across here and you find a little pack, a little flock, mud ducks, they call them, or mud hens, you can be assured that that's where the aquatic vegetation is, and you can be assured there are bass in the area. All right, look for the coots, catch you a bass just like that. Stay with us, we're coming right back to Central Texas, just outside the capital city of Austin.
Be sure to join Fox Sports Outdoors again next week, Thursday at 5:30, or catch the repeat airing Saturday morning at 8. And you can always watch the latest episode in full HD on the front page of our website at foxsportsoutdoors.com. Plus, catch up on all past episodes by clicking the archive button. And see lots of our how-to and product videos by selecting the how-to button. Join our online fishing community. Just click the like button on our Facebook page for access to daily posts with lots of fishing news, videos, and frequent giveaways. And stay up to date with all the latest fishing information and photos by following our Twitter feed. Fox Sports Outdoors is brought to you by Motor Guide Trolling Motors. Motor Guide, because accuracy matters. Academy Sports and Outdoors, right stuff, low price, every day. And Exide Technologies, powering the world forward.
Welcome back, everyone. It's time now for the Ask the Pro question, your chance for advice from professional anglers. This week, Colby wants to know, when is it best to long line for crappie, and when is it best to cast? For the answer, we ask the man known as Mr. Crappie, Wally Marshall.
I'll tell you what, long line trolling is probably the best technique you can use post-spawn. That's because you're using multiple rods, you're covering a lot of area, and most of the crappie will suspend 3 foot to 4 foot deep in 20 foot of water. So if you're casting, your lure is going down below the fish. When you're looking for fish on your depth finder and can't see them, they've moved up into the water column. So I'm going to give you the best tip. Post-spawn, tight line troll. Spawn, either vertical jigging with one rod, vertical, or tight line trolling. But then after the spawn, they're all over the banks. Then you can start casting. But remember, I like a bobber with the jig.
Thank you, Wally. If you have a question to ask one of the pros, simply go to our website, follow the Ask the Pro link, and let us know. Now let's find out which big fish photo wins someone a brand new pair of Costa sunglasses on the Costa Catch of the Week.
Hey, everybody, back on the boat ramp, and it's time right now for this week's Costa Catch of the Week winner each and every week. Someone wins a free pair of Costa sunglasses in our contest. He is Clay Hebert of Spring, Texas, showing a big 20-pound triple tail he caught sight fishing, wading the surf at Crystal Beach, Texas. If you would like a chance to be our next winner, just go to our website at foxsportsoutdoors.com. On the right side of the homepage, click on the Costa Catch of the Week box and follow the instructions to send us your photo. And if you'd like to see all of the great Costa frame and lens styles, go back to our homepage and click on the Costa logo. It's there you can see all of the 580 polycarbonate and glass lenses in all the various colors and all of the beautiful frame styles, including the frame I was wearing on this week's episode. This one is called Prop. Next up on the Academy Right Stuff, it's the right gear if you want to catch spring bass at your favorite fishing lake. And it begins with a great rod and reel. This is the brand new, just introduced to the market, Lewes Mock rod and reel setup. This is a 7-foot medium heavy action rod. It's an all graphite rod with a microwave guide system that keeps kinks and twist out of your line. It's a beautiful rod with the wind grips, just like they put on golf clubs, feel great in your hand, and a perfectly matched Lewes Mock speed spool reel, and you can tell it easily identifiable on your shelf by the matching green color. And for the baits we use today, on your right is our spinner bait. That's a 1/2 ounce spinner bait, chartreuse, gray, yellow, and white in color with dual blades. That's a nickel willow leaf blade backed up by a gold willow leaf blade. Willow leaf is the way to go when you're fishing hydrilla. And that's a lipless rattling crankbait. Red has always been my go-to color in the early spring. That's a 3/4 ounce size to get down a little deeper. This past year, I saw a really good movie called Arrival with lead actress Amy Adams. And in a poignant scene toward the end of the movie, she turns to lead actor Jeremy Renner and asks this question. If you could see your life from beginning until end, would you change anything? So, I have the same question for you. If you could see your life from beginning until right now, would you change anything? Well, the truth is none of us can change anything about our past, but we most certainly can change something about our future. There's still time to mend a broken relationship, get a better job, be a better mom, dad, or husband, get closer to God, improve our health. Any of those things can turn on a simple choice, a simple decision by you or me. The question is, will you make that choice to rewrite the future history of your life? I'd like to tell you about a brand new feature that we've added to our website. It's a search box on all of the hundreds of videos that we have available. Just go to our website, foxsportsoutdoors.com. Click on the Archives tab, and then you'll find that search box. Put the name of a lake, a species of fish, a type of fishing, and any video or show that we've done on that subject will come up in that search box. I think it'll prove handy. Check it out on our website. From Walter E. Long Lake in Austin, Texas, until next week, I'm Barry Stokes. Be safe, have fun. Bye-bye, y'all.